And this is very similar to how D3 does its joins. In the case of two tables, let's think of table one as our data file, in this case, data.tsv, where every row is a row in our file. And table two here, for the department, are all the HTML and SVG elements on our web page. And when we perform that magical data join, we simply associate every row in our data file with the corresponding element on our web page. In the case of our scatter plot, we are adding circles based on some common key that associates the two elements. The question naturally arises, what happens to rows in the tables that either don't have a match or elements on our web page that don't have corresponding data to bind to? Well, that is exactly what the special selection, .enter, that follows the data bindings for. And before moving on, just to make this example a tiny bit more concrete, in D3, there's the idea of a key that maps data to elements. As long as the data has the same key, in this case department ID, as to an HTML element that has previously been bound, they'll map to the same. Let's say, for example, on the first time through our code, we have an empty selection for the circle elements before the data bind. When we bind our data to the empty selection, think of it as creating something of an imaginary placeholder that has the value of our data. So in this case, for every row in our data table, it'll actually create an adjacent second department table. The .enter selection corresponds to all of these elements in this new mirror table that the data bind creates, which then get appended to whatever we first selected, in this case, the SVG element. So on the first time through, there's no circles on the page. We bind data, select all the bound data to placeholder circles that are not yet on our page, which there won't be any. And then for every one of those, we append a circle to our SVG element. Now, if we wanted to rerun this code without changing data or without changing our selections, nothing will happen. The reason being is that since the data never changed, the key of the bound data never changed. So our enter selection, which corresponds to all the new elements to draw on the page, will simply be empty, so we don't append anything new. In theory, we could run this line of code 100 times and our chart won't change, as long as our data and our selections don't change. And again, this is one of the strengths of the declarative syntax and allows us to build complex animations where only some elements of our data or some elements of our web page actually change from one frame to the next.